Welcome to my C# for Space Engineers tutorial, Hello Galaxy. The first thing we are going to do is create a new station. I'm going to place a solar panel, programmable block, and a beacon, since that's all we'll need. Now that we've got the blocks placed, let's take a look at the programmable block and start coding. First, we'll take a look at the programmable block's interface. It looks similar to most other blocks except for two new buttons: Edit, which lets us create the scripts we will be running, and Run, which will execute the script we have input into the game. Here we have the code editor. Let's take a look around. The most obvious part of the code editor is the text editor. This is the area we will type all of our code into. Check code is probably the most important button here. It lets you see if your code is properly formatted. Remember and Exit saves your code and closes the code editor. Remember Code saves your code. If you want to make sure that a crash doesn't erase your work, this is a good button to get in the habit of pressing. Finally, we have a Browse Workshop button. This is where any saved and subscribed scripts can be found and selected for easy loading. Alright, let's do some coding. The first thing you'll notice is the void main thing. This is the entry point of the script. Every script requires void main to be present, or it will not work. Let's start by creating our first object, a list called blocks. C# is an object-oriented programming language. This means that everything in C# is treated as an independent entity, and the relationships between these entities are what make the program work. Let's break this line down, shall we? List. This is a class. It's a container. It holds a bunch of similar objects. Think of it as the computer's way of writing down a bunch of similar items for quick reference later. Next, we have this IMyTerminal block thing in an angle bracket. This tells the list that we want to hold a bunch of terminal block objects in the list. The terminal block object is easy to remember. If it is found in your control panel, it is a terminal block. Next, we have the word blocks. This is the name of the object and how we will reference this list. You can call this almost anything you want, but there are a few very simple rules. First, you can't call it anything that already has that name, so you can't call it main or list because those are already taken. Second, you can't start it with a number. Third, you can't have any spaces in the name, and fourth, with the exception of an underscore character, you cannot have symbols in the name. We have the equals sign. This is the assignment operator. It says to take the value to the right of it and store it in the object or variable to the left of it. New is a keyword that tells C# that we want to make a new object instead of copying one that already exists. Now we repeat the object again, in this case, list IMyTerminal block. Finally, we put parentheses at the end and finish the line with a semicolon. The semicolon is very important. Think of it as the period of C#. It tells the system, I'm done here. This is important because you can actually have a command that spans multiple lines, usually for readability purposes, and the semicolon tells the system when you are done with the command, rather than assuming that you finish at the end of the line. So to summarize, we are telling the system that we want to make a new object called blocks, that is a new list of IMyTerminal blocks. Okay, so we have an empty list. What now? Well, let's load it. Keen has provided us with something called the grid terminal system. This allows the programmable block to access the grid and find blocks for us to manipulate. Let's tell the system what we want to find. We'll use the getBlocksOfType method. A method is a list of commands that are prepackaged, either by the system or yourself. This allows for an easier time because you don't have to remember to do a lot of complex things over and over again. You can just write it once and tell the system to repeat that sequence over again. The getBlocksOfType method requires us to tell it what type of block we are looking for. In our case, we will get a beacon block, so we'll use IMyBeacon in the angle brackets to tell the system that's what we want. Next, we stick the blocks list we created before in the parentheses here so that it will get populated by the grid terminal system. Now that we have a list of all the beacon blocks, what do we do with it? The easiest thing is to make a new beacon object called beacon. So let's do that now. Put an I by beacon and the word beacon, then equals, and then the word blocks. After blocks, put some square brackets and the number 0. Why do we do this? Remember how I mentioned it is a list? Well, we need to find things in the list, so we use something called an index. Computers start counting at 0, so we are telling it to look at the first block in the list. Next, we type the word as, and finally, I my beacon. This tells us that we want to cast the object in the list from the I my terminal block type to an I my beacon block type. C# is very strict when it comes to type. It may be a bit cumbersome at the beginning, but it protects you from making mistakes in your code that may be hard to figure out later. Casting allows you to convert an object or variable from one type to another. Now that we have our beacon object, let's set its name. We will use a method built into the blocks called setCustomName. Type in beacon.setCustomName, and in the parentheses, type in quote, hello galaxy, end quote. Close the parentheses and end the line with a semicolon. Let's click the check code button. We should get an indication that there is nothing wrong. If you see a red box, check the code and make sure it is exactly like mine. Double check the case of all the letters too. C# is case sensitive, so a single misplaced capital or lowercase letter can cause problems. Once we save and exit the code, we can press run. You'll see the beacon's name change from beacon to hello galaxy. You have just run your first script. If you want to play around with it further, edit the code and change Hello Galaxy to something else. Every time you run the code with a different message, the beacon will have its name changed to that new message. I hope you enjoyed my tutorial. Please subscribe and rate and put any questions down in the comments.